This video will show you how to adjust the settings of your Intermatic IOS-DOV-D PIR and IOS-DOV-DTD dual-tech dimming sensors. Before any adjustments can be made, the Decora wall plate must be removed so you can take off the bottom cover. The first three dip switches allow you to set the time delay, which is the amount of time for the lighting to stay on after no motion is detected. The default is 15 minutes, which is on, off, on, but can be set for 30 seconds, 2 minutes, 4 minutes, 8 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. Refer to the chart included in your instruction sheet for the dip switch positions for each setting. Dip switch number 4 sets the sensor to either occupancy or vacancy mode. The on position is occupancy mode, which means the lights turn on when motion is detected and then turn off after the time delay once no motion is detected. The off position is vacancy mode, which means the lights must be turned on manually but then turn off automatically after the time delay once no motion is detected. Dip switch number 5 is for synchronization when you have two dimming sensors wired to one fixture. In the on position, the second sensor can either dim or turn the lights on and off. In the off position, the second sensor can only turn the lights on and off. If only one sensor is being used, leave dip switch number 5 in the on position. Dip switch number 6 enables walkthrough mode. In the on position, the light fixture will be turned on for 2 minutes when motion is detected. If no motion is detected after 90 seconds, the lights will be turned off 30 seconds later. If motion is detected after 90 seconds, the sensor will refer to the time delay settings once no motion is detected. In the off position, walkthrough mode is disabled. To set the ambient light level, turn dip switch number 7 on and wait 30 seconds for the current ambient light level to be measured. Once programmed, if there is less ambient light than the initial setting, the light will turn on when motion is detected. If there is more ambient light than the initial setting, it will not turn on when motion is detected. Dip switch number 8 enables ultrasonic technology in the dual-tech sensor. With PIR sensors, dip switch number 8 has no effect. The mode selection switch takes you into programming mode and also allows manual lighting control. In the on position, the lights are always on. In the auto position, the lights refer to the sensor settings. And in the off position, the lights are always off. The dial adjusts the sensitivity of the sensors. On the dual-tech model, there are two dials, one for ultrasonic and one for PIR. On the PIR model, there is only one dial. The PIR dial has a sensitivity range from 60 to 100%. The ultrasonic dial has a sensitivity range from 20 to 100%. To program the light levels, move the mode selector switch to the off position. Hold down both the left and right buttons at the same time. The red LED becomes solid, indicating that you're in programming mode. To enter the high-end trim setting, press the right button once. The light will blink one time per second. High-end trim sets the maximum amount of output at the highest dimming level. Now press the right and left buttons together. The current high-end trim setting is indicated by the number of LED blinks per second. If it's blinking 3 times, you're at 100%. To change it to 90%, press the right button twice. The LED will flash 2 times per second. To change it to 80%, press the right button once. The LED now blinks once per second. A chart is included in your instruction sheet with a guide to these high-end trim settings. Now hold down the left and right buttons to confirm the setting and exit high-end trim mode. To exit programming mode, change the mode selector switch to the auto position. The low-end trim level is the output level at the lowest dimming setting. To adjust this setting, move the mode selector switch back to the off position. Hold down both the left and right buttons to enter programming mode. Now press the right button twice to enter the low-end trim setting. The LED will blink twice per second. Now press the left and right buttons together. The LED is blinking once per second, indicating that the low-end trim level is set at 10%. To change it to 20%, click the left button twice. The LED will blink twice per second. To change the low-end trim to 30%, press the left button three times. The light will blink three times per second. A chart is included in your instruction sheet with a guide to these low-end trim settings. Now hold down both the left and right buttons to confirm and exit low-end trim mode. The initial light level setting is the default level that comes on when motion is detected. To adjust this setting, enter programming mode by moving the mode selector switch to the off position and holding down both the left and right buttons. Since we are already in programming mode, we will skip this step. Press the right button three times. The LED blinks three times per second, indicating that you're in the initial light level setting mode. Now hold down both the left and right buttons together. The LED is flashing five times per second, indicating that it is set to 50%. To change it to 40%, click the right button four times. The LED will now blink four times per second. You can change the initial light level setting in 10% increments from as low as 10% with one click of the right button, all the way to 100% with 10 clicks. For this example, we will leave it at 40%. Now press both the left and right buttons to confirm your setting and exit the initial light level setting mode. To exit programming mode, move the selector back to auto. To reset your dimming sensor back to the factory default settings, move the mode selector switch to the on position. Now hold down both the left and right buttons until the LED blinks twice. Your dimming sensor has now been reset. Move the mode selector switch back to auto to enable the sensor. And you're done! You now know how to adjust the settings of your Intermatic IOS-DOV-D PIR and IOS-DOV-DTD dual-tech dimming sensors. And if you have any questions or need help at any step in the process, you can call or email technical support at the contact information listed on the screen. And be sure to check out our other videos on YouTube or visit our webpage for more tutorials.